Okay, so I'm in Rhode Island now. I've stopped and seen some family. I have a lot of family that lives in this area. Got to help build a fence, all that fun stuff. Got to go hang out at a farm. I didn't video any of that, but that was another thing that happened. So I was gonna go to, there wasn't really much I had planned between here in Rhode Island and getting back home, except for maybe going to the Outer Banks in North Carolina. I have been there before though, in 2019. That was actually the first time I ever went on a solo trip, was to the Outer Banks. I just tent camped on that one. It was fun. So I was thinking, instead of doing that, my family is actually at it's a place called Surfside Beach. It's just south of Myrtle Beach, and it's back in South Carolina. And like, my whole family is over there. They're having a big little get together. And I kind of want to go join them. I haven't told them that. They think I'm going to the Outer Banks, but I think I'm just gonna make a beeline for it. So I'm about 14 hours away now. So I'm just gonna start driving and just kind of show up there. I think that'll be fun. And plus, I kind of want to see them getting all sad. People ask me all the time in the comments, like, are you lonely? Do you ever get blah, blah, this and that? And I guess, yeah, kind of. I kind of want to go home now, so. Fly just flew in here. Got to go drive through places like New York City area. I mean, it's on the highway, but it's just it's such a nightmare. The place is just too much happening. That's another reason why I kind of decided not to go to Outer Banks, because I went during the off season, like early spring. So it was really cold. No one was there. But this time of year, everybody and their brother's there, and I don't know. This is a pretty cool little rest area. Not only are there no places to actually park, it's just kind of like a free-for-all. There's also no like resting chairs, not even an outhouse or like a porta potty or whatever. So, you know, people just get out and walk over there for a little bit and then walk back. It's pretty gross, but I'm gonna make lunch now.
Brother!
I made it. Alright.
Phone's up back. Get your mom around here.
Okay.
What?
Hey!
What the world?
Mommy! Made it. Hey, Ginger.
Aw, I love you.
Me too.
Yeah, I started driving. Drove like 16 hours yesterday or something. Alright, the rest of them are down on the beach or something, so I gotta go find them.
Hey, I'm wondering if you might show up.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, I'll stay here the whole time. Hey, Graham. Leon! Hello!
Leon!
Well, I'm back in my hometown now. When I was editing this video, I realized that I never actually videoed an outro to the video, so I'm doing that now. So when I'm shooting this, it's November, and then the rest of the video was shot back in like mid-August or somewhere in there. Since I've gotten back, I've just been working nonstop, doing the audio job that I've been doing for the past few years. It's been great. I've had lots of good opportunities, so everything's good there. I just want to say, now that this series is kind of finished up, thanks to everyone who's been watching and keeping up. I think this is the 43rd video since I started doing the van build. It's a lot of videos, and some of y'all, I'm pretty sure, have watched just about all of them. And so I really appreciate everyone that's been kind of coming along for the ride. It's been cool talking to people in the comments and this and that. I've enjoyed it a lot, so thanks. Videos are not done, though, by the way. I still plan on putting some videos out. I have a couple standalone videos I want to do, like some tips for safely camping in Walmart parking lots. I want to do a video talking about like some things I would have done differently with the van build, although I'm happy with it, but there's still some things I learned from it. And other videos, kind of like retrospective videos along those lines. I also still have some little trips planned. There's a shorter trip I want to take, kind of going along the Gulf, maybe into Texas and Florida, Louisiana, those areas. And that would be in the van again. But then I have some other trips planned. Actually, when I'm videoing this tomorrow, I'm videoing this now and I'll edit it tonight and then I'll schedule it to post tomorrow. But tomorrow, I'm actually going to go up and do an overnight hike up in the mountains. So when this video goes up, I'll be starting that. I've never actually done an overnight hike. I've hiked all these crazy hikes, but I've never done an overnight hike. So I finally bought a backpack for it and some gear and this and that. And I'm going to go try that out because I think it would be... I just think it would be a good thing. At this point, I might as well have done some overnight hiking and stuff. But I think it would also be great for like national parks because you can get deeper into the parks and explore more. So if I ever go out west, I'd like to have those skills and the gear for it. So anyways, I'm going to video that as well. So there'll be some little videos like that and some short trips up in the mountains and blah, blah, blah. So there'll be content still coming up is what I'm getting at. In terms of like long-term plans, I'm actually going to sell the van, I think, which was the plan from the beginning. It is kind of sad because I do like the van, but I want to try and recoup some of the investment if I can. And vehicles are selling pretty well right now. So I do plan on selling the minivan probably... very early this coming year in 2022. And if it does, I'm going to try to sell it as a camper van, but if it doesn't sell, then I'll convert it back into a minivan and just sell it that way. I guess at a bit more of a loss, but whatever. It was worth it. Other long-term plans, like travel plans, I would like to go to Europe sometime in 2022. This obviously is very dependent on like COVID and what's going on with that. But yeah, sometime late spring, early summer, I'd like to go explore some other countries because I've never left the US before. My brother might even come along with me if I do that. So it would be a fun trip. I've applied for my passport and such, and I've started doing some basic planning, but there's a lot of ducks that I need to get in a row before that ever happens. And there's not 100% guarantee it will, obviously, but if I do that, you know, I'll be videoing it and this and that. It would definitely be a different style kind of channel. It would be more, you know, it's not like van life at that point. Obviously, it's more staying in hostels and backpacking and things like that. But anyways, my point is there'll still be stuff on the channel. It's not like just dead now and done. So I'm actually at work right now. We have some weird audio issue we need to figure out. So I'm going to head in and see what's going on with that. But, yeah, I'll see y'all in the next one, I suppose. And thanks again to everyone who's been hanging out and watching all of these. It really does mean a lot.